What's up, guys? Pastor Rob here with another reaction video. This time I have a special guest.
What up?
Do you do Chucky or Chuck?
Chucky, whatever you want.
I know him as Chucky Molnar. Yeah. This is an amazing time for you guys, for me to share with you guys, because Chucky is probably, I've probably known you the longest of anybody in my life.
Yeah, over 30 years.
Now, me and Chucky were best friends growing up, but I haven't seen Chucky in person. And I mean, we've never really spent time together, in probably 20 years?
20 years, yeah.
At least 20 years.
Since we were like high school, like sophomore, junior.
Yeah, something like that. I left right around 8th grade. So this is really, you guys are joining us for our kind of reuniting. What's that? I'm hearing that peaches and herb.
Is that reunited and it feels so good.
That's the one. The reason I asked him to join me is because Chuck was in a heavy metal band. What genre would that be?
Metalcore, I guess. Groove, whatever. Metalcore. We never really put a name on it, man. We just played.
All right, metalcore groove.
I guess,
the band was called Gorilla Fight.
Yeah.
Y'all played some pretty big venues.
Yeah, locally we played House of Blues, Hard Rock, did the Earth Day Birthday Fest a couple of times. Fun times, yeah.
That's a pretty big deal around here.
Yeah, we had a nice local following.
But the reason I wanted him to join me today is because Chuck recently became a Christian. Probably what?
About 4 years ago or so. Well, three, four years ago.
Recent is relative term. Recent to relative to me.
Comparatively.
Comparatively speaking. Yeah. Chuck's fairly young Christian, so it's kind of neat seeing his life change. So I thought it'd be great to have him on the show, to introduce him to you guys. He, as a musician, he appreciates the music, being a bass player. You play several instruments, correct?
Yeah, but bass is the only one I will play in front of people.
All right, so that's his main thing. And I like the bass, too, because it's funky, and it has that sort of hip-hop thing going
on. That's right, we dictate the song.
Yeah,
you dictate. Don't forget that, guitar players. We run the show.
There goes the channel. There's going to be bad comments everywhere. That's it. Y'all just Chucky Molnar at hedoesn'tcare.com if you want to send him an email. One of the things that Chucky, now, me and Chuck hanging out back in the day, Chucky's family, you're from a mixed family.
Yeah. My mother is born and raised Jamaican.
So we hanging out with him, we listen to a lot of interesting music.
That's right.
His
everything.
Yeah, and your dad is a Vietnam vet.
Vietnam veteran, yeah.
So there's the whole '60s, the whole Jamaican thing mixing up, and so we got introduced to a lot of good music, and you were inspired by a lot of funk
and blues stuff. It evolved as I grew as a musician, but the core was like funk and bluesy R&B kind of stuff.
Mm. So how'd you end up in a metal band?
I was renting a room off of one of my friends. And the next door neighbor just happened to be in a real popular metal band.
Mm-hmm.
And when their band broke up, well, we became pretty close talking over the fence.
Mm-hmm.
And
Tim the Tool Man.
Tim the Tool Man. We'd meet at the fence and just talk for a long time. And then he was starting a new band and he liked the way I played. So that was my introduction to heavy metal music.
Interesting.
So it was a big shock for me going from really trying to just groove to going to heavy metal and playing so together, and tight. But I learned a lot musically. I mean, a lot. And I learned that what I thought the heavy metal community was going to be was nothing what I liked, what I expected. It was a wide open, accepting culture that blew my mind.
It's funny you say that because I'm learning the same thing doing this channel. Very accepting. I mean, I'm a pastor jumping into the heavy metal community and they're like, welcome.
Yeah, open arms, dude.
Which is really neat. So I appreciate you guys. Now, we posted a question in our YouTube community asking people for bass recommendations so that we can show him something. Again, I ain't really caught up with him in so long. I don't know what he has heard and hadn't heard. So obviously he heard a lot of those things. But one that kept jumping out, and I've seen this in other comments, is the band Primus.
Boom.
With Les Claypool. Now, unfortunately, we've heard the band.
We totally know who they are.
Now, here's the cool thing about this, though. When's the first time you heard Primus?
From you.
Really?
Yep, when we were kids.
So
the C's the Cheese album.
The C's the Cheese. So I introduced him to Primus.
That's right.
So I thought it'd be great to revisit Primus together. I'm already getting goosebumps. I know. Even started the thing.
I know.
It's like we're going back in a time machine to a time when things were simpler, hanging out in your house.
Yeah.
We used to grab broomsticks and pretend we were...
Look in the mirror, which he had a little Stratocaster-looking guitar, and we'd air guitar and sing. And I'm talking little boys. We were young.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're definitely, it was so fun, so inspiring for me. You know, music was always a part of my life. Metal wasn't a huge part of my life, mm-hmm. but it was hip hop influence. But things like Les Claypool, like I said, Faith No More with Epic, mm-hmm. Deftones, a couple other bands that had a little bit of that rappy delivery. Yeah. I like that stuff. And Primus, I like because they're weird.
Yeah.
Every time I heard a song, Jerry was a race car driver.
Sorry, dude.
So what I thought would be great to do today is listen to the one song that anytime I hear it, I think about you, which is the song Tommy the Cat.
Yeah.
You ready for this?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
I haven't watched this video in forever.
Oh man, this is great.
As a bass player, when you hear that for the first time, you imagine that's you.
Yeah.
Like, what does it take to do that?
Can you play that?
Yeah.
Yeah? Oh, that's so cool. Yeah. I gotta see that.
Well, I remember this song a meal ago. Truly a wonder of nature, the serpent predator. Tommy the Cat had many a story to tell, but it was a rare occasion such as this that he did.
Hey, still remember it? Wow.
Oh, look at homie. He did this and sang.
Yeah?
Played that bass like that.
Wow.
Yeah, all the other bass players that I can tell you, that is not easy. Their creative process must have been real. I would love to be a fly on the wall and watch them create.
That's
a
visual.
I know. I bet he's hilarious to hang out with.
Oh, yeah. I bet. Yes, that's great. Tell me you can't do that. Can you?
I'm not going to ever claim that. I can try. Like a little ghost
Do you want to lay down with me? Say, Pepper, do you want to lay down by my side? Pepper, do you want to lay down with me? Say, Pepper!
That's great.
Oh, yeah. There was so much of this video I don't remember. Yeah. I remember the bartender stuff.
Say, Pepper, do you want to lay down with me?
That's great. That was a great experience to do that with you, bro.
Yeah, man.
That really was. That was cool. Like taking a time capsule, like the Back to the Future.
Oh, yeah.
Going back in time with someone that you grew up with, watching you grow over the years, watching you do your thing with the band is was really inspiring to me.
Yeah.
If I have to admit, sipped a little haterade. I was like, oh, he's in a band. How come I didn't get in a band? This is great.
It's much different on the inside than it has. Oh yeah, man. Because you're playing locally. You're not famous.
Mm-hmm.
But it's so intimate at the show, you know, and a lot of people really get into underground music.
Mm-hmm.
So they love your music, they love you, but then Monday morning you got to get up and go to work. You know what I mean?
That's true.
So it's like
after the mosh pit,
after the mosh pit, and everyone's jogging, whatever, screaming your name, and then Monday morning you got to go to work.
I remember hearing you mentioned on the local radio station. Mm-hmm. For Earth Day birthday.
Yeah.
And I was like, my boy.
Yeah.
I know that guy. I felt like I knew someone famous. I'm like, yeah. I know that guy. I know the bassist in the band.
Ask my mom, I was famous.
Yeah. That's how my parents feel about me.
Oh,
sometimes.
Dude. So I'm 40 years old this year, my mom still talks about me like I am this rising star.
Well, I believe in you, brother.
Hey, I believe
in you.
So too,
now
bro.
You play in the worship band.
In the worship band, yes.
And is the name of the worship band?
No, there's no name. It's at the church I attend and just the worship team, you know. It's all glory to God, so it's not, you never put that first. It's all
dude, let me tell
God.
You something. Yeah. I'm going to have to go there because if you play like Les Claypool during the worship service, I'm in.
I wish.
we'll have a church service mosh pit over that joker.
You know, where are we do, you know, God wants us to play with skill, so. Mm. Wherever he takes you during the service is where you go.
Mm. Now, I believe all gifts are from God, of course.
Oh, me too.
So the way we're designed, your ability to play, Les Claypool's ability mm-hmm. to play, whether you believe in God or not, it doesn't negate the fact that he created you
yeah.
and that you have those gifts. So whenever a gift is displayed, intentionally, unintentionally,
yeah.
it shows the glory of God and the majesty
amen, yeah.
and of his handiwork in his creation. So to me, it's a beautiful thing. That's one of the things I love about this channel. I love about music, and sometimes Christian people don't understand it. They're like, "Well, hold on, you're bobbing your head to the music as if in approval." Absolutely,
yeah.
I'm in approval of the beauty.
They're so gifted and so talented.
I have no idea what the song was about, so yeah. I can't really like comment on the lyrics. But what yeah. I do want to comment on is how music can cross barriers, mm-hmm. can break through barriers, build bridges, oh, yeah. transcend time.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, think about that. A song me and you used to play. I mean, gosh, I don't know. What year did that come out?
Like 90s, early. It
had
probably.
To be
yeah.
80s, 90s yeah. easily. Probably, I don't know. Gage looked at it. It had to be in the 80s or 90s. And we're just teenagers at best,
yeah.
young kids. And we're listening to this music, have no idea that 20 years later, we'd be sitting here
revisiting
using it,
that moment.
Revisiting
yeah.
it, using it to talk about Christ.
Yeah.
And how even though that music could have led you astray, as some people might say, in fact, it led you on a journey
yeah.
that led you to Jesus.
Yes, right.
Right? You tasted the world. You experienced the world.
Yeah.
You saw everything it had to offer. You experienced a taste of fame. Local you know, fame's yeah. fame, but local fame's fame.
Okay,
you can try to downplay it.
I'll take it.
You'll take it.
I'll take it.
Can I get your autograph later?
Mm, sure.
All right, cool. Yeah, autograph my shirt. So you taste the world, and yet you found it wasn't, well, I'm putting words in your mouth because you didn't tell me this, but mm-hmm. I'm assuming you discovered at some point it didn't deliver as promised.
Yeah. For me, I thought everything was going great. Mm-hmm. You know, life was good. My family was healthy. I had a job, but then when you get touched by the presence of God, and I asked for it,
mm.
and it's just from that moment on, my life was changed.
Mm.
My awareness to everything that I did was just peaked, you know? And to experience that, you cannot help but want everyone to feel that,
mm.
you know? Like people will tell you, you know, people that aren't Christian that I know, why do I to do that in my house? And if you believe something to be the absolute truth,
mm.
why would you keep that from your friends and mm. your children and
amen.
Your family, right?
Because
mm-hmm. it's so beautiful and it's so powerful.
Mm.
You know, I'm not gifted with preaching. I don't know the book as well as I wish I did.
Mm.
I don't read the Bible enough. Mm. I need to do more. But it changes. Your life starts all over, basically. Mm.
Born again.
Born again. It's really like that. You are born again.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing. And then you want it for everybody, you know?
Mm.
And seeing this channel right here, what you're doing, bridging the gap, especially with metal music, because there's so much imagery involved with metal music, you know? Mm. And a lot of people get consumed by that.
Mm-hmm.
Whether they even know what the imagery means or not,
mm-hmm.
they just love that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it does not go with Christian imagery at all, you know?
A lot of the time.
Bridge that
But they gap, are spiritual.
Yes, sir.
It's spiritual in most cases.
Yes.
So I see the spirituality.
Yeah.
And I know they're searching for mm-hmm. something that they haven't found yet.
That's right.
They found an erroneous version of it, a misrepresented version mm-hmm. of it, or a false characterization of it.
Yeah.
And they reject that a lot of the time, and so do I. I'd reject hypocrisy. I reject a lot of the things that they reject as well,
mm-hmm.
which don't make up true, actual Christianity.
Yeah.
So part of the reason we started the channel was to sort of build the bridges as well as... tear down those straw men and rebuild actual truth so that mm-hmm. they can see Jesus and Christianity for what it is, what it truly is, which is freedom in Christ, freedom from the wages of sin, which is death, right?
That's right.
Freedom from God's wrath for sin. And it's free. By grace, you are saved through faith.
You don't have to be anybody but who you are to be a Christian, you know? You don't have to be this super... too goody two shoes person to be a Christian, right?
Yeah, yeah. Well, God changes you from the inside out. Yeah. So when you become born again, mm-hmm. like you said, it's like a new life.
Mm-hmm.
You don't desire. We use the analogy like we were talking earlier. It's like you. The Bible says you're a slave to sin.
Yeah.
So, but then Christ comes, sets the captives free, as the scriptures say,
mm-hmm.
pays off the taskmaster, pays off the slave owner.
Yep, your debt is paid.
Now you're free.
Mm-hmm.
And freedom in Christ is the most beautiful thing because now you can experience true joy. It's not sullied by sin anymore. Mm-hmm. It's not sullied by this restricted desire to only taste sin and death, mm-hmm. right? You experience life. You
experience life. Everything that you used to think you weren't really, I don't want to say addicted, I don't want to, because not everyone's fully immersed and stuff, but the things that you used to lean on
mm-hmm.
to get by.
Mm-hmm.
They start to shrink and shrink and shrink and shrink.
Your idols, if you want to call
them. There you go, your idols. You know, whether it's alcohol or drugs mm-hmm. or even, I don't know, music sometimes. Mm-hmm. You know, you dive into your music, but you're not doing it to glorify God.
Mm.
So
the beautiful thing, like you said, becoming a Christian isn't about following a set of rules to earn favor with God. You can't.
No.
And interestingly, that plan was abolished. Adam had that ability.
Yeah.
But when Adam failed, God said, okay, no more works. Mm-hmm. I'm going to offer you salvation.
I got hold my book. I got this.
Yes. Right? Yes. Yeah, hold my book.
I got this.
Hey, I've never heard that. Usually it's hold my beer.
I was trying to be correct for the channel.
I know. So it's not by works. God said, like, what'd you say? Hold my book. Hold my whatever. Beer. So hold my beer. Hold my whatever. I got this.
Pretty much let daddy handle this, son.
Even better.
Daughter, whatever. Daddy's got this.
Daddy's got this. Here in Genesis, I think it's 3:19, somewhere in 3, he promises the one that would crush the head of the serpent, the first gospel, the first hint of a savior to come to undo what was done in the garden.
Mm-hmm.
So from that time on, they always looked forward to that and trusted that the final sacrifice would come. Sacrifice would come to wash away the sins of the world, which mm-hmm. was ultimately Jesus. It was mm-hmm. a foreshadowing of what was accomplished by Christ. We forget that, and we try to work our way to heavens. Work our way to heaven. Heaven. Heaven's the Murgatroyd. Right? Heaven's the Betsy.
I forget what show that was.
I don't know.
Heaven's the Murgatroyd. I don't remember. It was something.
Alf?
A show or
no,
something.
I don't know.
Get the mic, right?
Jeez, I keep losing track after you after we do that. What was I saying?
Heaven's a Murgatroyd.
Oh, so Isaiah.
Yeah.
Isaiah says his righteousness is but filthy rags.
Ah.
So Isaiah says the best that I can do is but a filthy rag.
That's right.
No, it gets worse than that. He's literally talking about a used menstrual cloth.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So his best is but a used tampon.
That's right.
Maxi pad.
Mm-hmm.
Insert. Mm-hmm. Not pretty.
Yeah.
So, hey, God, here's what I did. Here's my goodness. Paul in the New Testament says his works, the best he ever did, is dung. It's garbage. Now, Paul kept the law. Paul was a Pharisee. Paul did more than any of us could ever imagine. And he says, all the best I've ever done is but dung. The actual literal word there is a lot stronger than the word dung.
Yeah.
But, you know, this is a Christian channel. We got to filter it. So dung's a pretty strong word.
Yeah, yeah.
But Paul, it's only used one time in the New Testament, in fact. So he's literally, like, it's a pretty harsh word. Yeah. And he's being very emphatic about how worthless our works are before God. Wow. So it is by grace, through faith, that we are saved. We repent, turn from our sins, trust in Jesus Christ for forgiveness of those sins, and he will fill us with the Spirit and save us.
That's right.
And he will carry it out to completion. He will give us the strength to walk.
Yeah.
And when we fall, he picks us back up. It's already forgiven.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
That's right, man. That's why Christians walk around, you know, you're confident.
Confident.
There's a fresh air about.
Yes.
I know that's how I felt.
Yes.
When it became absolutely real for me, the air came through my lungs differently.
Mm.
Everything was different.
Mm.
And it's not easy.
You no longer feel the master.
No.
The slave master.
No.
That you now have a new master,
mm-hmm,
who says you are free.
Yeah. And like I say, it's not easy. We sin every day.
Mm.
We fall back into old ways all the time.
Mm.
But it's a lot easier to go back when you know what the truth is.
And plus, you know the master is not going to come and beat you.
He's not going to come and beat you. You're forgiven.
He picks you up. Yes. Yeah. You're already forgiven. There is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus.
That's right.
Only those who are in Christ Jesus don't have condemnation. So everybody else walks around with condemnation.
Freedom.
Freedom is a good feeling.
Freedom.
A great analogy. We're getting carried away here. We're running heavy on time.
Yeah.
Great analogy. It's like you spend your life in prison.
Yeah.
You're hanging with the boys in the cells. And I used to be a chaplain in Orange County Jail, so I know what it's like.
I didn't know that. That's cool.
Yeah, for a long time. Yeah. Well, a couple years. They become comfortable, and they almost don't want to leave. They dread the day to leave because then they got to return to responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
The guys that are there are longer. It's harder.
Yeah.
But imagine you grow up your whole life there. You've got the free food, everything seems comfortable. Then one of your friends gets let free, and you're like, where'd he go?
Mm-hmm.
That's weird. Who would want to be out there, right? Then he comes back, and he's like, you got to see this, dude. You got to experience. You got to come. It's freedom out here. You don't. Then they're like, you're crazy. You have no idea what you're talking about. You're crazy. This is what we know, and this is what we love.
That's right.
And then they stay there. And a lot of the world does that.
That's right.
And as a Christian, I'm like outside of the prison going, come on. It's freedom out here. It's not what you think it is.
Yeah.
Come join us. Yeah. Anyway, we're getting carried away here. Thank you guys so much. Chuck, thank you for coming.
Oh, thank you for having me.
That was fun.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for joining us on this reaction video. Chuck, again, thank you. It was a pleasure having you.
Thank you for having me.
Great catching up with you. Yeah. It was great hearing your testimony.
Yeah, from now on, we need to make sure we get together a lot more.
Yeah.
20 years can't go by again.
Y'all hold him accountable.
Hey.
Hold him accountable. Yeah. Make sure he comes and hangs out with us some more. and if you enjoyed the video, please comment, like, subscribe. You can email me at connect@growthproject.org. You can find me on Facebook. I'll have all the links down in the description, as well as links giving you some more information on some of the stuff we discussed in this video. So until the next video, insert catchphrase here. We'll see you on the next video.
Boom. Well, I remember this old war meal ago.